Hi, I'm Tricia Wallace, and I'm here today to bring the word to you. It's taken from Hebrews 11, verse 6, and it reads, "And without faith, it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him." Let us pray. Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for this hour. I pray that as I bring your word, that it will be light, that it will be peaceful, that it will bring a blessing, that it will build up and not tear down, that it will affirm and edify. Holy Spirit, go before me. Speak through me. Open the ears of your people. And I thank you in advance in Jesus' name. Amen. The topic today is activating your faith. Now, if you want to activate your faith, you must first know God and Jesus Christ and know that they both exist. As believers, our faith comes from the wisdom of God and the hearing of His word. It is not from the power of just speaking words. You say that you know God, and you say that you love Him, and yes, we do. But this does not exercise your faith in Him or isolate you from your problems. But if you seek God, if you anchor your faith in His word, and also if you are obedient to His voice, then He will reward you and causes your problems to be isolated. Now, when our faith is fueled by the word of God, it rejects superstitious beliefs. By faith, we learn to trust in the undeniable word of God. The word of God is like a mirror to our souls. When we look into His word, it changes our image from glory to glory. So when life happens, and you are faced with unreachable expectations that overwhelms you, harden not your heart. Seek God. Call on Him. Because you know what? You're more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. Sometimes when our expectations are delayed, as human beings, it's very simple where we feel disappointed and we lose hope. But don't lose hope, my brothers and sisters. The Bible tells us hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. Let me say that again. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. Remember, faith is the substance of things we hope for. And we serve a God of hope, who He will fulfill our longings for us. And guess what? He specializes in the things that may seem impossible. So hope. Hold on to your faith. Activate your faith by hoping. Trust, believe, and hope. Now, these are words which are activated by your faith. Be confident in it. Be joyful in hope. Be patient in affliction. And be faithful in prayer. Remember, faith without works is dead. So keep exercising your faith and it will live. When you study the Word of God, you are building yourself up on your most holy faith. Now, one act of faith can change your life forever if you believe. Mark 11, verse 24 says, "Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you already receive it, and it will be yours." So go ahead. Start thanking God in advance for all that you had put before Him, for all that you had prayed for all that you have petitioned for. Go ahead. Thank Him. Believing, activating your faith, knowing that He already gave it to you, that the Word of God will manifest in your life. It shall come to pass. If the doctor may give you a bad report, let prayer be your first resort. Pray in faith. Hope in faith. Believe in faith. Then stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. See how God will manifest His goodness in your life. See how He will shower you with blessings where you don't even have room, just because you activate your faith. And guess what? No good things God will withhold from those who walk uprightly. I encourage you, seek God. Seek Him with your whole heart. Seek Him for someone else while you're seeking Him. Because when you lay before God for others, it draws His attention. And in His response, He will make a way in the wilderness for you. Because you put aside your situation and you think of putting someone else's situation before Him. God is faithful. So when you get your bills, and yes, they're due, so many things is happening right now. You have people losing their jobs, so their bills are due. You have people who lost loved ones, where their hope is dim, brokenhearted. When you seek God, seek Him with your whole heart, and He will come through for you. Activate your faith. God will carry you through. When your back is against the wall, and I know sometimes you don't even know who to call, call on Jesus. But call on Him, knowing that He is there, that He is listening with His arms stretched out for you. He just wants you to come. He just wants you to activate your faith in believing Him. Acknowledge Him. It is He who calls you out of darkness and into His marvelous light. He's faithful, He's willing, and He's able. I encourage you today to activate your faith by trusting in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. Lean not to what they're talking about in the news and other social media. Lean not to just that thing what presents itself before you. In all your ways, trust Him. Seek Him. Look to Him. Activate your faith in Him, and He will make your path straight. It's not by just mere words. God is real. Jesus is interceding for us daily. The Holy Spirit comfort us. He guide us in all truth. So when you feel sad, when you feel burdened, when you feel overwhelmed, look to the rock who is higher than I. He's just an arm lent away. I thank you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word. Thank you for allowing us to exercise faith by trusting and hearing and reading your word, your infallible word, your written word, your on time word, your now word, your word what will build up our faith in you. So many situations has happened. We have had losses, emotional loss, physical loss, spiritual loss, financial loss. But we know that you are God who provides, you are God who sees, you are God who knows, and you are God who supplies all our needs according to your riches and glory. As we activate our faith in you, let us exercise your word, what is written. Your word to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Your word to know that you are a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. So this day, I thank you in advance for the blessings what you will pour out on us. Healing, provision, covering, abiding, us being hidden in you. Comfort your people, God. Forgive us of our sins and heal our land. In Jesus' name.